inside of you. We never diminish. The God of heaven, we take you from glory to glory to glory.
Yesterday, and they said she should go up on a team.
Then she called me. And the throat has started scratching her. It has entered her. The manifestation, everything there. I said, daughter, I can't come there, but I believe in God, I serve. I pray for her. He said, daddy, as you were praying, a cold air entered into me, and this something died. Yeah. And within the same week, they came to do another test. She was negative. I pray for you. Amen. Every attack against you, I command it to backfire. Amen. I command it to backfire. Amen. I command it to backfire. Amen. For no weapon fashioned against you will ever prosper. Let me stand up against you. But I stand on the mountain of God. In the name of Jesus, I command it to scatter. Amen. I command it to scatter. Amen. I command it to scatter. Amen. In the mighty name. Amen. He's alive.
Amen.
He's alive.
Amen.
He's alive.
Jesus is alive forever. He's alive. Amen.
He's alive. Amen. He's alive.
Jesus is alive forever. He's alive. Amen.
He's alive.
Amen. He's alive.
As they were dancing with their break dance and everything, I was just admiring them. Wow. Wonderful. Dance in the midst of the presence of God. God is always good. Hallelujah. Let me go straight to the message because the time is against me. I may not be able to preach today because the time is already against me, but let me give you a few exhortations. Today, I will be talking about breaking the invisible barriers. Breaking the invisible barriers. Hallelujah. And we don't take time, I will go straight to the point. Barriers. What are called barriers? Listen, barrier is something such as a fence or a wall that is put in place to prevent people from moving easily from one area to another. Sometimes, or that some things or that some materials may be used to block or intended to block a passage. It's also a barrier. A barrier could be vocal, words, a rule. Thou shalt not do this in any country. It's a barrier. But we are talking of the invisible barriers that have been manipulated by the devil. Barrier exists. It exists. You cannot say no. It's there. They are trying to prevent access to destiny. They attempt to prevent access to destiny. So people, you are here. Your destiny, you are prevented not to reach your destiny because of barriers. And you find out that you are struggling. You are struggling. You are struggling. But I'm also here to tell you, this one may sound strange. Some barriers are actually your stepping stone to greater height.
Amen. Amen.
Not every barrier that is actually from the devil, or is from the devil. No. There are some barriers that are there. You have to go through it to go to the next level. Goliath was a barrier. But David, because Goliath was so big, if he were so small, he would have been taking little steps to climb up. But there are some barriers. When you finish them, they become your stepping stone. You step on it. Before you know it, you're on top. Amen. David removed Goliath and stepped on him and catapulted him to the highest. Today, my mission is that every Goliath in your heart, in your life, in your destiny, blocking you, they will become a stepping stone for you.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every Goliath in your life will be brought down for you.
Amen.
1 Corinthians chapter 16, verse 9. It says, for a great door, an effectual, is open unto me, and there are many adversaries. Doors are open unto me, Paul said. He said, but there are many adversaries. I don't know which door is already being opened for you, but yet you are struggling. Most of you, like near success syndrome, you are about to get there which you want. And all of a sudden, I was watching yesterday. I discovered that secretly, the German government has started deporting people again. They have started deporting people. That's why coronavirus is there. From lightage, they can be watching you on TV. It's true, it's on newspaper. They have started deporting people. But this time, as a church, we are going to come against them. No one will be deported here.
Amen.
No,
Amen.
We will not allow it. There are barriers. They will bow before the God we serve. Particularly those that have decided to serve God. You cannot be deported.
Amen.
You cannot be deported.
Amen.
We are going to pray over it. We are going to agree. We are going to stand with it. And God will serve. We answer us.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So barriers are there. I've just told you there are two ways. There are barriers created by the devil to block you. The witch is the wizard. The God, your father, your mother were worshiping before. Now you are going to church. They have become your enemy. They are reacting in the spirit. You see them. Some of them, they come to you, they feed you. Some become human beings to make love with you. I know some theologians will not accept that, but it's true. Because I cast out devils, and most of the time the demons are forced to talk, and they have confessed. Say, who are you? He said, it's a demon in the father's house. And he has become a spiritual husband or a spiritual wife. But these are barriers and they must get out of the way today.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
But I just told you, some barriers, the moment you can convert them, is your stepping stone.
Amen.
You see, when you are in the school and you are in a certain class, they will give you an exam. It's like a barrier. It's for you to move to the next class. Yeah. If you do not pass that exam, you may remain where you are. But these exams are not to destroy you. It's for you to be promoted.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So some so barriers are not necessarily evil. They are there for you. Look at, for example, you have a house, particularly if you are from Nigeria. I don't know about other countries. My country is the best country in the world.
Amen.
The best. Our president is the best president. Because why? Whether he's alive or dead, you don't know. And you go to Nigeria, you build a small house. If you, the wall you will put around it, which is called barrier, is bigger than the house. Because armed robbers are there, kidnappers are there, ritualists are there. They now have a new name, hoodlums, and I'm there. And the one sponsored from Aso Rock with SUV, they are more now in the streets. So as a result, you will build a barrier by yourself around your house. Why? It's for good thing to protect yourself because you are coming from the land that is the best. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Nigeria's land is the best land.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Come on, agree with me. Say amen.
Amen.
We cannot be praying for Nigeria and be speaking bad. No. No, we can't do that. Nigeria is the best.
Amen.
But let's come to reality now. I'm trying to tell you what is called barrier. Some of them, so that you understand what you are saying. Some of them are created by enemies. Not to protect the enemies, not to come to you. Rather for you not to go forward. They put it there to protect, to prevent you. Some of you, you have been in Europe. Some of you like 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, 40 years. But your papers have not even materialized. And some of you are married, but it's like The money, only God knows, every day by day you are only praying to stay there. You have never settled down. Some of you, you are married, but you wanted to have everything that should be in that family, but there is a barrier. Those things will be cleared away today.
Yeah. Yeah.
They can't stay because the God we serve is the God of fire. Yeah. Hallelujah. Why am I trying to explain it this way? When you know the meaning of barrier, then you know how to kick them out.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He said, for a greater door, an effectual door is open, but there are many barriers. There could be very many. God may open a door for you, but the devil will still want to put something there.
Mm.
What do you do in the midst of this? That is where I'm coming. What do you do? The doors are open for you, but there are adversaries. How do you handle them? What do you do? That is what we want to examine, and we rush it today, and we go through it very fast, and by the time we finish, you will be able to understand. But before I do that, I want to go to Zechariah chapter 1, and let me just read verse 17 to 21. Listen, it said, cry, yet, say, thus saith the Lord of hosts, my cities, through prosperity, shall you be spread abroad, and the Lord shall yet comfort Zion, and shall choose Jerusalem. Verse 18, then lifted up my eye, and I saw, and behold, four horns. Somebody say, four horns. Verse 19, and I said unto the angel that talked with me, what be this? And he answered, these are the horns which have scattered Judah. Every horn that have been assigned to scatter you, they are going to scatter themselves.
Amen.
He said, these are the horns that have been assigned to scatter Judah, Israel, and Jerusalem. Verse 20. And the Lord showed me four capitals. Say, four capitals.
Four capitals.
And I'm here to tell you, the four capitals are here today.
Amen.
And four capitals are here today.
Amen.
Not just one, but four capitals.
Amen.
Ah, thank you, Lord. Verse 21. And then said I, what are these to do? And he spoke, saying, these are the horns which have scattered Judah, so that no man did lift up his head. But these are come, the four capitals, to spread them, to cast out the horns of the Gentiles, which lifted up their horns over the land of Judah to scatter it. The four capitals are there to restore you back to your original shape.
Amen.
To restore you to your destiny.
Amen.
And those four capitals are the angels of God that are here right
Amen.
Now. I pray those angels to work for you.
Amen.
In the mighty name of
Amen.
Jesus. He said that no one will lift up in your family. You are wondering, why is everybody, they are talking of good things. When they are celebrating, somebody is having a new house, a new car, a new this. When will it ever happen in my home? You are the next.
Amen.
You are the next.
Amen.
I just watch TV. We see some people, they drop their car, they are feeding the poor. And I cannot even feed myself not to talk on the poor. What is happening? No. The Lord said, I should tell you, you are the next to feed the poor.
Amen.
You are the next.
Amen.
Because those barriers are leaving your way today.
Amen.
They are leaving your way.
Amen.
They are not meant for you. They cannot stay.
Yes, Lord.
They cannot stay. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
But like I said, let's take it primarily, step by step. What do I do in this situation? Let me tell you, it's very simple. But at the same time, because it's so simple, many people don't take it seriously. Things of God are too simple. Things of God are too simple. I'm going to preach in a German church. They may be hearing me, they're watching me right now. I'm going to preach, and I said, the first thing, my son was there, he was the cameraman. I said, bring the sick, let them line up. The sick. I said, they should bring them. I said, listen, I'm not going to pray. I'm only going to stand, and I'll ask them to check. The sickness will be gone. I said, I'm not going to pray. Not pray. That's how I was directed. Later, I said, let me even prove it so that they will not say there is any kind of... I called one of the women there. I said, you come and stand here. Don't pray. Point your hand on the pain. She pointed her hand. I said, don't even speak a word. So after a while, I told them, check your pain. One by one, all of them will be healed.
Amen. Amen.
All of them, they were healed.
Amen.
What is the meaning of that? Listen. There are a level we have come to whereby you don't really fight the devil. You just only know what to do. It looks so simple and it works. The first thing on the list, you must be born again. It's so simple. He said, Pastor, is that what you want to say? Yes, but that is the key. You must be born again. He said, your sin has separated you from the gods. When you are born again, that sin is removed. The barrier automatically will collapse. But you see, the problem we have is that many people, they love God. They want to go to church. Then they are struggling, they are praying, but they are practicing religion and not reality. They have not really understood. Nobody could really divide the word of God to them to know the difference between religion and reality. Going to church every Sunday does not mean you are born again. Singing in the choir does not mean you are born again. Preaching on the altar does not mean you are born again. Speaking in tongues does not mean you are even actually born again. These are the things born again child we do. It's true. But first of all, have you given your life to him? Have you received him? Have you received him into your life? You know, if you ask some people, they say, since I was born, a Christian. Have you heard of something like that before?
Yeah.
It does not exist. It's not like that. In Acts of Apostles chapter 10, there was a man who was a benevolent man. He was praying, giving out his arm. His name was
Cornelius.
Cornelius was his name. And the Bible says, God appeared to him in a dream and said, send for Peter. When he comes, he will tell you what to do so that you'll be saved. He was a giver. His prayer was coming to God, but he was not saved. If he had died, he would have gone to hell. You see, it like you say, I love to read books. You go to bookshop, you buy books. Every Sunday they will bring newspaper for you. You are already reading. You read and read. You solve mathematics. You do chemistry. You are reading everything at home. But you are not enrolled in any university. You can never graduate.
No.
You first of all have to be enrolled. Your name has to be on that register. Is your name in the book of life? Is your name in the book of life? Have you given your life to Christ? That is where it starts from. You have to be born again. Your name has to be on that register. Then you are qualified. When you now read, you are a student of that university, of that school. It counts. Rather than you are reading, everybody know on Facebook, you are preaching. You are born, you are not saved. You have to make sure your name is in the book of life.
Amen.
The disciples went out. Jesus gave them 72 of them power to cast out demons and all. They came back and they were very happy. Demons were subject to us in your name. Jesus said, cool down, baby. Cool down. He said, not like that. Don't rejoice because demons. Rejoice because your name is in the book of life. Rejoice because your name is in the book of life. Are you born again? Are you born again? Have you received him, his life into your life? I preach one dangerous message here with many people. We say, what are you saying? I said, many of us will say, I've given my life to him. Your life that is so useless, full of sin, he doesn't want that your life. Receive his life.
Yes, yes.
Not you giving him your life. Which life do you have to give him? Which life? Full of lies, full of everything. Sin. We were born into sin. We live in sin. Receive him. For God so loved the world that he gave. When he gives, what do you do? Receive.
Yes,
sir. Have you received Christ into your life? Have you received Christ into your life? That is the first step of breaking the barriers. Then you will be enlisted into the army of God. You will have all the weapons to fight the battle. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I said it's so simple. If I start measuring the point, But many of you will say, is that what you want to say? I know about it. I go to church. My pastor is already preaching it. You must be born again. That is not what I'm saying. Your pastor may be sleeping, working, dancing on it. But are you born again? Not whether you had it before. You individually. Let me tell you. Some people will say, I was born to be a Christian. God is not like that. Individually, you must come to a point when you receive Him into your life.
Amen.
Every one of us. And as a pastor now, I may say my children are there. Because since they were born, they grew up in the church. No other place they know. It's in the church. All of them. But that does not mean they are saved. Each one of them have to identify by themselves. They have to receive Christ at a point in their life. I remember each one of them, particularly my little daughter, the day she broke down and was crying. Just yesterday here, Evita came to meet me, my first daughter. She's a Christian, she speaks in tongues. But yesterday, he said, I was watching Seed Rods, Supernatural. Something entered into me. I've discovered I'm not worshiping God enough. That as I keep on, I went into the room, and all of a sudden I started seeing vision. That was yesterday. And she came and told me, said, it's a different level I am. That is personal relationship with God. That's what you must do. When you do that, barriers will bow before you.
Amen.
Barriers will bow before you.
Amen.
It's not your prayer, your prayer. Jesus had already done what he needed to do. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Somebody said, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Today, what took us our time? I think the praise and worship was really much. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Number two, be confident. Be confident. The barriers are always there. But you see, like a dog, even me that is preaching, I have to learn that. Before, I feared dog more than anybody here. When a dog, if somebody is coming with a dog, me, I will just say, let them pass. Because they don't, we are never friends. But now, gradually, I'm becoming bold. So when I see them, I pretend. I move. And I find that the dog also respect me. Hallelujah. It's the truth. I can't tell you lies. I fear dog. So before, but it's gradually dying now. What does that mean? When you have confidence, the dog will sense.
Yeah.
They will not come to you. But when you are afraid, they will attack you.
Yeah.
Not because you are possessed, it's because you have fear. Refuse to fear. Be confident as a child of God. That the demons and the barriers they put around, they will collapse.
Amen.
When you face it, you find out the demons and they may appear to you in your dream. You wake up, you are shaking. No! Say, I take that dream, I put it under the cross, I cast it with the blood. Move on with your life. Be confident that the God you serve is able to protect you.
Yeah.
When that confidence is there, that is what you need. That is your armor that we also need. Confident. Be confident of yourself. David came against Goliath. Where? I have said it over and over. All the Israelites were hiding. Their king, the throne trusted. Saul was hiding. And David came, a young boy. He said, brother, he came to give the brother food. He said, what are you doing? He said, shh, don't you see that man? He said, is that one of you are hiding? He said, we know you too much. He said, come on. What is wrong with all of you? They said, where is our king? They said, he's there. They said, shh, don't shout too much. That man. The whole Israel, he went to the king. King, oh my God. King, what will be given to the person that will destroy this man? So that this one, the confidence I have is not for nothing. It's for my profit. I want profit now. What will you give me? The king says, all the family will be exempted for tax. He says that all. I will give my beautiful daughter. David said, now you are talking. Let me go and face it. He said, don't go. Carry my helmet. They put it on him. David said, no. I don't need this one. Confident. He took the stone. He took five stones. Because Goliath has five brothers. There were five of them. If you read the Bible, I preach it one time. They are called the Zambubis. If you read the Bible. Zambubi means noisemakers. They are the Goliath in your life, they are noisemakers. Zambubi means noisemaker. That is the meaning of Goliath. And he took the first one. You see, I always say, If you look at the board here, it's so white. But David grew up in the bush, like most of you, with a catapult, like little bird. When you close one eye, you will aim, and I got it. But this one, you don't need to close your eye. You need to open your eye. No matter how you shoot it, you will hit him.
Yeah.
He was having confidence that this one, I can never miss it. And he released the stone, and David cut off the head, and he died. Today, do your hand this way. Say, I have the stone of David. In the name of Jesus. Every Goliath in my life, as I throw this stone, I bring you down. Somebody say one. Say two. Say three. Fire. Say Goliath. Go down. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. What I just told you, see how 1 John chapter 5, verse 14 and 15 put it. And this is the confidence that we have in him. That if we ask anything according to his will, he heareth us. There is confidence on his side of us. When you are born again, you have confidence on his side of you. The barrier, they are watching, they are looking at you to see if you are afraid. Have confidence. Have confidence. He that promised can never fail. Have confidence. Amen. Trust the God that you serve. Amen. Trust him. Trust the Lord. Have confidence. There is no mountain you cannot climb.
Amen.
There is no valley. Oh my God.
Amen.
You need a more baba. Have confidence.
Yes.
Confidence. And you are crossing over. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yeah. Verse 15 of it. If we know that he hears us, whatsoever we ask, we know that we have the petition that we desire of him. It's already granted.
Amen.
If we know, the problem is if not we answer us. If we have the confidence, we know it's already granted. Every barrier in your life, they are collapsing right now.
Amen.
Can you encourage yourself and have the confidence that the God yourself can never disappoint?
Yes, sir.
He can never. Can you have that confidence? Despite the pandemic going on, can you build up yourself and have the confidence in your soul, in your spirit, that the God of heaven will not disappoint you?
Amen.
You'll be surprised. Most of you, you know what to do. You turn the TV, this one is praying, pray. You turn this one, pray. You are only copying. Be original now. Have confidence in yourself. When you now join them, something will be happening. It's not the volume of prayer that causes all to happen. It is the confidence in you.
Yes.
Is somebody following me?
Yes.
Have the confidence. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Our Lord is good. Hebrews chapter 3, verse 19. So we see that they could not enter in because of unbelief. Simple word. So we see that they could not enter in. Why? Because of unbelief. Most of you may have confidence, but if you are having doubts, there is no confidence. Unbelief will cause you not to enter. It's not because of the barrier, because there is no belief in you, no faith, no confidence. The Bible said that because of unbelief, because of their unbelief, they could not enter. They could not enter. Hallelujah.
Amen.
They could not enter. That is Hebrews chapter 3, verse 19 we just read. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let me rush the other side so that the time is already against me. I have prayed this message one time before, but the Lord gave me this morning that in a different way to preach it again. Number two, the anointing breaks the yoke. Engage the anointing of God in your life. Let the anointing of the Holy Ghost. You can't do it with your power. Let the anointing of the Holy Ghost in you work. Isaiah chapter 10, verse 25 to 27. For yet a little while, and indignation shall cease, and my anger in their destruction. And it shall come to pass in that day that the body shall be taken away from off thy shoulder, and the yoke from off thy neck, and the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. It's the anointing that breaks the yoke. Let the anointing get yourself anointed. I'm not talking about poor oil. No, people are misunderstanding. It's not the oil. No, not the oil. Please don't misunderstand. Speak in tongues. speak in tongues, speak in tongues, speak in tongues, until you find out your body is hurt. At times I pray, brethren, I find out it's like I'm standing in front of oven, heater, fire, burning. Get yourself more than that. Speak more in tongues. God said, I speak in tongues more than you all. I speak in tongues more than you all. Many of you don't pray. And you speak in tongues for 5 minutes, you're already tired. You go to preach again and be looking for what to eat. Speak in tongues. Every day, load yourself. Load yourself before you go out. Spend time. Pray. The anointing breathes in you. Somebody say, I hear, Pastor. I'm trying to rush it. It's so much. Number four. This one is the most dangerous one. Worship and praising God. Despite what you are going through, if only you can go into the deep to worship God and to praise Him in the midst of crisis, no matter what you are going through, the enemies cannot stay. It invites angels. When you are worshiping God, you invite literally the host of heaven. Not only angels, the host of heaven will be present. You can pray and pray wrongly, but you can never worship and worship wrongly. Anyhow you worship, it will hit God. But you may pray, your prayer may not be. It might be sanctimonious piety. That means speaking from fleshly. It's not. There may be obstacles, even in your speaking words. But in worship, direct to the throne. In praising God, direct to the throne. In thanking God, you can't thank God wrongly. When you engage in this one, those barriers, they will submit to you. They will submit to you. Do it more. Do it more. Most of you go to your music in your phone. Only the one that are bringing courses. It's summer. This is summer sadness. And you play it. And that is the popular music in Germany now. I don't know that. And this is the summer sadness, because they just want to compose a lyric to me with S. They said this is summer, the summer of sadness. And you are playing, you see people dancing. They are dancing. And tomorrow sadness is happening. And they say, where is it coming from? Why not fill your mobile phone, your house, with worship music? Why not surround yourself? Your earpiece. And somebody will talk, what are you listening? You are just in a different level. Hallelujah. Engage in deep worship. Somebody say, deep worship.
Deep worship.
Number five, fasting and prayer. That is what we are doing today. Jesus said, this kind will not go except by prayer and by fasting. And that is what we are supposed to be doing. Matthew 17, verse 12, verse 21. Say, this kind, how will this kind go not out? But by prayer and fasting. Spend time to. Today is fast. Why don't you fast? Most of you today, you are eating panediam. In Dutch, so filet has shown kartoffel gegessen. Fruit too. Some are eating kartoffel already. Can't you not fast at least? And get that stupid thing out of your way. Challenge yourself and say, I'm going for 2 days, 3 days. Not because I want to lose weight, but because that thing must get out of my way.
Yeah.
No water, nothing, all the way with God.
Yes, sir.
When you do that, you are building up. You are removing barriers. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, I will stop here because the time is fast spent. Forgive me. Number seven. Number six. Love the things of God. We are here right now. Some people may say it's cold, it's hot. Yes, the heater may not be working well. The air conditioner may not be. We need more of it. Find out what you can do. Love the things of God. Just love the things of God. Fall in love with God. There are flyers. When you close, pack them. Love the things of God. I know of my sister, my daughter here, when she just went to join the church. Every Saturday, you will see her with flyers on Saturday in the street, distributing it, sharing it. And I'm not surprised. God granted her papers to stay because of working for God. Hallelujah. I'm talking to Sister Hannah. Because today I have to mention some names so that, Pastor, you are not just talking. Every Saturday, she was there with Brother Freedom. They would come here every Saturday, collect flyers, and they would go out. alone and start sharing it along the street. How will God not bless them? Fine. If I didn't mention your name, I know what you are doing is great, but I can't mention everybody. But that is just an example. All of you are doing great. God bless you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Number 7. You must be planted in a church. For barriers to go, listen to what the Bible says, Psalm 92, verse 32. Those that be planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the court of the Lord. They shall bring forth fruit in old age. They shall be fat and flourishing. It's what the Bible says. You must be planted in the church. Barriers will bow before you. You will flourish. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Well, I ended up with Obadiah 1:17, which is a popular one. But upon Mount Zion, there shall be deliverance.
Amen.
Say, I'm delivered.
I am healed.
I am healed.
I am healed.
When you are a child of God, you don't need deliverance. You are delivered. When you are a child of God, you don't need healing. You are healed.
Amen.
When you are a child of God, you don't need money. You are there. You have the power to make wealth.
Amen.
It may not be there, but it's already there.
Amen.
You bring them out. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Barriers can never be on your way.
Amen.
It can never be. Let's stand up. Let's pray. Let's pray. Let's pray. Let's pray. Say, in the mighty name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I thank you for every word I receive. Father, wherever I have not accepted you, I receive you right now as the Lord of my life. Come and live on the side of me. And be my Lord.
My Savior.
My Redeemer.
I give you my life.
In Jesus' name.
Jesus.
And I command every barrier.
Everybody.
In the name of Jesus.
The name of Jesus.
You cannot stay.
Now
that I know the truth.
I
uproot you out of my way. I uproot you out of my way. In the mighty name of Jesus. No barrier is permitted. In my life, in my family,
in
the church,
in
Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.